What's going on, people? It's your boy Detroit Kingpin coming at you with another video right here on Lionheart TV. Yeah, man, Lionheart TV. Yeah. So please make sure you hit that like button, man. It's my birthday, man. So hit that like button for me, man. You know what I'm saying? And if you're not subscribed, what the fuck are you waiting for, man? Golly. Come on, man. It's no brainer. Anyway, look, you see what we got on the screen right here, man. Your boy, yeah, another member of the Kardashians. Oh, my God. You can see it on the screen. Your boy Travis Scott, man, is under pressure, man. He had a wild concert, man. Some people died. I don't know what happened. You go to a concert, you trying to have a good time, and then in the midst, you don't make it home, man. That is a problem, man. Trying to go to a rap concert. Come on, man. You can't do nothing these days, man. Death is the result. So here we go, man. We're going to check this video out, man. But before we get into that, man, come on. Come on. You know what we doing here.
Scott said.
You know what we doing here.
Houston police officially launching a criminal probe into the Astroworld chaos that left 8 people dead and hospitalized dozens more. Police also confirming reports that some of the victims may have been injected with drugs by a needle, with a
injected
security guard
foot?
Among those possibly pricked.
Of a security officer. He was reaching over to restrain or grab a citizen, and he felt a prick in his neck. And the medical staff did notice a prick that was similar to a prick that you would get if somebody's trying to inject.
The fuck?
Rapper Travis Scott says he's devastated about what happened while he was performing.
I'm honestly just devastated. I could never imagine anything like this just happening. We've been working closely with everyone to just try to get to the bottom of this.
It's worth noting, this isn't the first time the Grammy-nominated rapper has been in trouble with the law. On two separate occasions in 2015 and 2018, Scott pleaded guilty to misdemeanor charges of reckless conduct after telling fans to jump barricades, rush the stage, and bypass security during concerts in both Chicago and Arkansas. Abby, I want to come to you first and get back to what originated as a rumor, but the idea that people were feeling syringe jabs coming out of nowhere.
What the
I can't
fuck?
Imagine. Again, our hearts and prayers go out to the families of everyone who died, because to think
For
that
real,
you're going
though.
To a concert, it's an innocent
too,
thing. You're going to have fun, and there's someone
old.
Potentially pricking other people in the neck and injecting them with drugs. I'm speechless thinking about it. And actually, some of the names of the victims were released in their photos. John Hilgert, 14 years old. Brianna Rodriguez, 16. Franco Pitino, 21. Kenya, 23. And then when you hear about Travis Scott and the fact that he's encouraged this type of behavior before,
he
and he's actually been sued and arrested for it and hasn't learned his lesson, I hope that other artists are seeing this and they're encouraged to not, encourage this type of behavior, for lack of a better word, at their concerts as well.
And Charlie, we are just learning that the first lawsuit in this case has now
been filed on behalf of one of the victims.
It seeks $1 million
against
Travis Scott, Live Nation, which is the organizer, and Drake, the performer who at one point was also on stage with Travis Scott. I think this is just going to be the beginning.
Shit. It's over with for
you.
When
we talked about this last night,
it's
all
over
all we
with
really
for Travis
is,
Scott,
my goodness,
man.
How terrible! How tragic! You know, our hearts
they
went
got
out
it,
to the families.
Though. They got it.
But you know, as new information comes out, you start to wonder what the hell
they
is
got
going
it,
on
though.
In this place. And you always want to try to find some sort of reason, some sort of explanation for why something happened.
Especially that ain't
if
no
it's
motherfucking
senseless.
Reason.
It's human nature to sort of grasp for explanations. Well, and it's something like this. You often don't find explanations. But if in fact this guy Travis Scott, who has a record of trying to encourage his fans to rush the stage.
What?
If in fact,
wow.
And so all the videotape will be
I see
gone
what's going
through.
On
all
here. He encouraged
people,
his fans
you know,
to rush
Instagramming
the stage.
And doing stuff from there off of
it's
their phones.
His fault.
It's all going to be looked through. If in fact he did that again, he should be locked up and he should be sued for millions of dollars. He should be sued out of existence. If he did
ooh,
this concept
he said he should be sued
that,
out of
that there
existence.
Are consequences
this
for the things
not
you do,
good
the things
him.
You say.
But let me tell you,
in a
Travis
crowded,
Scott is gonna get off.
Environment like this,
him,
it really is, it's shocking beyond words.
And Joe, this we're just learning of this lawsuit. The investigation is still underway. We don't know who's going to be held liable here. However, in the lawsuit, they call this predictable, that this was predictable.
Damn,
and the fact
that
this has happened in the past, I just wonder, I mean, his fan, even if Travis Scott didn't encourage people in this moment to rush the stage, if his fans know that he has done that in the past, I'm wondering if that could come into play here.
Exactly.
It's a great, great question. And look, you look at precedent in these situations, Alicia, right? And you look at a guy named Paul Wertheimer, and he led an investigation of a 1979 concert crush that killed 11 people. I believe it was in Cincinnati. And he says that Houston authorities here did not do enough to keep the crowds safe. Let me quote him. Quote, the crowd in Houston never should have gotten that big and dense. It was a preventable tragedy that happened because safety precautions were ignored and because there are millions of dollars here to be made, unquote. That about wraps it up. Yeah.
Yeah, and Abby, you know, I think there's going to be a question now. I think that's going to have to be addressed is how do you handle crowd size at these festivals, right? With 50,000 people
50,
in attendance at this festival.
People,
when you're talking about general admission, you kind of assume,
that's
you know, one person goes, a lot of other people
of
are going to go as well.
Man.
Yeah,
shit.
I mean, I think that's exactly it. I don't really know man, if you can control
really
a crowd of that size.
People,
so I think it would have
you know,
to come from the organizers
pushing,
of not selling as
pushing.
Many tickets. Of course, they will lose money, but that money is worth it. To, you know, spare someone's
five,
life. And I listened to someone else
way.
Talk about
another
this also. They said maybe have some assigned seating and not allow a mosh pit type of situation like this. There are certain things
mosh
that can be
pit.
Done. And, you know, I do think that there was a lot of law enforcement from what I read there. Again, I said this yesterday, but the Houston mayor said there was more security at this event than there was at the World Series. Of course, you know, there are 50,000 plus people at this. But, yeah, I think, Alicia, you hit it on the head. I don't really know if you can control 50,000 people. Mm-hmm. That's
right.
Nearly impossible, I can imagine.
Well, we will continue to watch this.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere.
It's not looking good for your boy. It's your boy Lex Scan, man. Please make sure you hit that subscribe button. Turn on the notification bell so you know every time your boy drop another banger.